It was the introduction of the first Mercedes-Benz CLS class 13 years ago that vaulted the term four-door coupe into our collective vocabulary, for better or worse. That car's arcing roof and shoulder line gave it the appearance of an elegant, four-wheeled airfoil, albeit one slightly melted at each end. Then the second-generation car arrived for 2012 with a similar roofline but a brutalist, squared-off rear that couldn't match the original car's delicate aesthetic flow. Now the third-generation CLS class has arrived. It has the now signature arched roof, regains a prettier tail, and has a brutalist front end that looks angry about something. We're not sure why Mercedes keeps playing hot potato with styling experimentation from one end of the CLS to the other, but at least this latest model once again can stop onlookers in their tracks. There is a hammerhead shark swimming through the front end design, with the headlights canted inward and bluntly framing the low, wide grille. The effect is not unlike that of Mercedes-AMG's GT sports car, although here the grille leans forward more aggressively. The car's tail has been lifted and smoothed, and it is garnished by jaunty trapezoidal taillights. As before, the swoopy four-door is based on the mainstream E-Class sedan. The two share their 115.7-inch wheelbase, but the CLS is lower, wider, and longer. Where the 2019 CLS breaks new ground is in its adventurously sculpted interior and the all-new inline-six engine that, at least for now, isn't shared with the E-Class. Oh, and it's also a hybrid. Get in line. The powertrain consists of Mercedes-Benz's new turbocharged 3.0-liter inline-six, a 48-volt electrical system, and an electric motor sandwiched between the engine and transmission. These components combine to produce 362 horsepower and 364 pounds-to-foot of torque, although the electric motor can pile on an additional 21 horses and 184 pounds-to-foot during brief boost periods. The electric motor also is capable of powering the CLS alone, in short spurts, and it enhances engine stop-start capability. Overall, it's quite a change from the previous model's all-V8 lineup. This represents the American market's first brush with the hybridized inline-six, a setup that is expected to proliferate throughout Mercedes-Benz's lineup and replace the twin-turbocharged V6 engines available in everything from the C-Class up to the S-Class. For the CLS, the engine earns the 450 badge. Non-AMG CLS models are thus christened with the CLS 450 label. Buyers can choose between rear-wheel drive or 4MATIC all-wheel drive, and every CLS 450 will have a 9-speed automatic transmission. A more powerful, range-topping AMG version of the CLS is anticipated to debut at the 2018 Detroit Auto Show in January. Dubbed CLS 53, it will be powered by an enhanced version of the new inline-six hybrid powertrain making around 430 horsepower. If you want a sleek four-door with 8 cylinders, you'll need to wait for Mercedes-AMG's four-door GT,